Barlow.
Oh, lovely to see you.
And you. Come here, darling.
Are you doing?
Hey, I'm all nice.
Great to see you, mate.
And you. I haven't seen you for ages.
No, no.
Get yourself on that couch. Come on, you. Now, do you want me to sit in the middle, or you're all right?
I think we'll be all right tonight, okay, seeing as you're here.
Do you know what, Robbie? I remember, cast your mind back 20 years, the Fridge nightclub, Brixton.
Oh, yeah?
Right, I'm booked as Lily Savage to do a bit of comparing. 7 foot, wig out here, a pint of cider in one hand, fag in the other. And I staggered into the dressing room, and there's all these little boys half naked sitting there. And I remember saying, friggin' hell, what is it, a creche? And you lot went, ooh.
I probably just went, Mum!
Now, look, 15 years is a long time to fall out. I tell you what, look at me as Oprah tonight.
Right, OK, then.
Shut it! Oprah, you're with a friend, right? You can say anything you like,
OK? Adopt me.
Yeah, all right. Right, get the papers, I'm adopting Robbie. Now, I've had Barneys with everyone. I mean, I fell out with my best mate for 3 years and we never spoke till I had the heart attack and he thought I was going to die and he didn't come to the hospital and butter me up. I wouldn't have left him anything in me will. Alveda. No, really. But what caused the fight? What was it?
Well, it was horrible.
It's you, wasn't it?
Oh, no, it's you.
What caused the fight? What did cause the fight?
You see, this is it, isn't it?
We were young, we were in love.
Yeah.
We didn't know what we were doing.
Now you've told them.
Yeah.
Well, I tell you what, that video you've done for your new single, bit Bareback Mountain, innit? Eh?
So, yeah.
Oh, I thought...
People have been saying it's a bit homoerotic, guys.
Homoerotic? Did you do the bit in the tent? I did get it.
The dirty Eric Bristow, I've been called.
But look, tell me, what were the last few months like for you in Take That? Seriously.
What happened was, I was 16, you were 18, 19.
Kids.
Gaz had been professionally working as a musician since he was 9. Was it 9 or 10 or
something?
Well,
you supported Ken Dodd, didn't you?
I did, yeah.
So, you know, Gaz wanted to be a solo artist and, you know, so did I. And, you know, by the time I was 16, he was 18, he's like, I don't want to work with this Muppet. And, you know, that was basically it, though, wasn't it? No, you know, he saw himself as a solo artist and he'd have every right to. He was immensely talented. And, you know, I wanted my share of the cake and we were young and we had egos and that's basically
you
what
you know
happened.
What? Hit the fan, yeah. In other words.
Yeah.
He's saying now, says he. Yeah. He's so like a member
I'm
of my
observing.
Family. But the last day was in the rehearsal studio, wasn't it?
Yeah, I was drinking an awful lot.
Yeah.
You know, whatever it was that was keeping me on the straight and narrow had broken. And underneath, you know, under the pressure of everything, it's a weird time being in a really successful boy band because all of a sudden you go home and there's like 200 girls outside your house and your mum closes the curtains in 1991 and then doesn't open them until 1997 when they've all gone. You know, there's lots of contributing factors to what happened, you know, too long to say now.
Yeah.
But the last couple of months in the band, you know, I was just a bit of a wreck and, you know, fully blown alcoholic and, you know, the first round with alcoholism was right about then when I was 20 and wasn't a happy time.
Was he getting on your nerves?
You know what, I must say, a part of coming back as a five...
What is a twat?
It's a pregnant stickleback.
Oh. I have a great answer then.
Sorry.
That's all right. I was just saying, part of us coming back as a five this time is to try and, you know, all those wrongs we did, and one of them we felt, as Rob, as the baby of the band, is we never looked after him as much as we should have done. And,
yeah.
And we're looking after him this time, everyone.
You're looking really well, you know.
Thank you.
You know something? That's very sweet. I'm going to tell you something. This is my philosophy, apart from que sera, sera, which I say every morning.
Right.
To hate somebody with passion, you've really got to love them first.
Right.
Because if you don't, you're indifferent. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
You've got that what I was thinking away, but I'm trying to find a polite way in the cards. But you know what I mean? But to, like, to wake up in the morning and think, oh, I'm going to... You've got to have loved them first.
Listen, I loved all the boys dearly. Yeah. Did all the way through Take That, did after I left Take That, and, yeah. You know, why I was so venomous about Gaz and why I was so venomous about the other boys was because basically I just love them to bits.
And also, if you're off the rails with the booze, you know, you say things to the press.
You're a bit confused, yeah. Don't know what you're doing.
Yeah.
But no, it is the truth, you know, I love the boys.
You're sarcastic there with me, Robbie, for a moment.
No, not at all.
No, but it's true though, isn't it? You know, when you're a bit, you come out with stuff.
Yeah, you do, and I came out with quite a bit.
How did you feel when he was calling you fit to burn?
Yeah, I wasn't too happy that week.
So tell me, look, how did you get back together? Who made the first move?
The boys were in Los Angeles, where I'm living with the missus, and they're recording The Circus, which was the last LP.
Yeah.
And LP.
That was your last long player, wasn't it?
It was, yeah.
And I think Marky dropped me an email and said, come down. And I was terrified, because they'd been back together as a four-piece for a while, got to know each other, were comfortable with each other. I'd said a few nasty things and didn't know what the reception was going to be, because I read your book. and the extra chapter that you put in after we met. Let's not go into it now.
You know what? My mother used to say about a couple, every pan has a lid. Well, I believe you, mate. There's the pan and there's the lid, I'm telling you.
What happened was, Marky dropped us a line and said, we're mixing the album in LA, won't you come down and see us? Yeah. And I had a toothache and I'd taken some Vicodin or something, and I was a bit wobbly and scared. Yeah, and it was Ida that made me push me through the door.
Yeah.
And I'm so glad I went, because we met up and I was welcomed very much with open arms, and it felt like the old days, but without all the...
Were you frosty?
Without all the rubbish.
No.
Oh, I bet you were.
No, we were excited.
Oh,
really?
Really
excited to see him.
Weren't you sitting there going, I'm going to have him. Going to have him.
No, not at all.
You know, it went...
That's really nice.
It went so well that the boys came up to my house the next night and me and you sat down and had the proper chat, didn't we?
Yeah, we did.
Unloaded, both of us unloaded. It was like this for me, I'm sorry. And he said, it's like this for me. And I said, I'm sorry. And I went off and got myself a Take That tattoo to commemorate.
Do you know what? Seriously. I haven't, like, known you, but you know, like, from day one when you're doing all the club, it's really nice to see you back together again. I hate seeing people fall out. Yeah. I mean, I really do.
Yeah, it's amazing, you know, when two grown-ups meet each other on a level and say sorry and really mean it, the amount of stuff that falls off your shoulders that you actually don't know that's there until it's gone, it's really freeing.
You feel better, don't you, for it?
Yeah, but both of you have got to meet at a place, you know, where you're both saying, yeah, I see my part in it and I'm really sorry.
Well, more later. More to come, folks. Yeah, we've got more from Robbie and Gary in a moment. Including, I don't know anything about this, Robbie's love of multi-poos, whatever they are. Plus, they're going to sing, so don't go anywhere. See you after the break.
Thank you.
I was just saying in the ad break, the lyrics to the new single, they're beautiful. Because they're so personal.
Did you do them? Yeah, I did them.
Yeah, but off again.
Yeah, yeah.
Didn't you have your fine hand in there, Gary? No.
I'm not responding.
No. Now, this new album, Robbie, this is a look of your career over the last 20 years. God, does it feel like 20 years?
Doesn't it? Doesn't. Yeah. You know, it does actually see the policeman getting younger. Yeah. Let's have a look at the track list.
I'll tell you what else is, when you run for a bus and you let off. No, really. I can sympathise with Anne Widdecombe. Every time they swear, she lets one go.
It's weird sometimes when I'm with the lads, I just don't feel as though I've been away at all, and it's been 15 years. Yeah. It's going like that. It gets quicker and quicker as you get older, isn't it?
You're a now married man now, Robbie.
I am as well. Yeah. I'm glad some of you cheered, because normally everybody goes boo. And then when I go home, I'm in bed with Ivy watching the telly, they're like, they booed me again. Oh, yeah.
Are you going to have kids?
Yeah, she wants them straight away. I quite like not having them straight away. She was backstage with the pig.
Oh, she likes the pig.
And I saw her eyes lighting up, and I knew, I thought, that's not a pig, Luke, that's a baby Luke, isn't it? I should get at it, shouldn't I, really?
You should do. Yeah.
We're trying to get him into the idea by bringing the kids with us to shows and stuff, but I think he's putting him off.
Are the kids in? Listen, when you go on the road, are all the wives coming and the kids coming and everything?
Oh, yeah. Yeah, we're having a crash this time.
Oh, God, yeah. Oh, yeah. Do you want a nanny? Nanny savage.
I think we'll get the take that thing done. Maybe not go on tour. We're not allowed to mention it. On that.
We will never mention the big tour next year.
But after that, I think, you know, me and the missus will probably have a kid or two.
I read in the paper you want a gay baby.
Yes.
You can't pick.
Well, you know, the Japanese are very clever these days. They come up with all sorts of things. And maybe they can sort out a gay baby for me and the missus.
Why do you want a gay baby?
Because,
you'll have to sit and watch Judy Garland 24 hours a day.
That's what I do anyway. Yeah. Sound of Music in the morning.
Oh, I can't bear the Sound of Music.
Cup of tea, cup of coffee. I am 16 going.
No. Nuns and Nazis and nannies don't do it for me, I'm sorry. Robbie, look, now we're going to have a look back at some of your best bits. You ready for this?
Yeah.
And it all begins with Take That's very first appearance on Wogan.
Oh, yeah. God, there
we go.
We've been tipped as Britain's answer to New Kids on the Block. Take That.
I think that the doors are always open for Rob to sing a song. He's more than welcome.
Such a shame. What a shame. Pitiful old
shame. Rum lad. Remember that? Robbie, very quickly, what is a multi-poo?
A multi-poo is our little dog, Poupette. We've got eight dogs and one of them's a multi-poo. And she's the one that begs the most when you leave, and I just can't leave her in the house.
But what are the... Is it, it's a poodle, yeah?
Maltese and a poodle, yeah.
They look lovely.
Oh, she's honestly the best. She's a little princess and she's daddy's little
Gary,
girl.
Tell him he needs a baby. I mean...
I know.
Oh!
He's my child. Aren't they beautiful? What do you think, David?
I think I'm keeping it.
Have you bonded?
Yeah, I have.
Isn't she a sweetheart? Look at that snotty nose.
Is that how big that one's going to be?
Yeah, probably. Ah. Listen, lads, do you want to go and get ready to sing? Where's your wife,
Alex?
Yeah,
here you go.
Get yourself on the couch, David. Danny, what do you think?
I want one.
I'm going to bring them. You can have one.
I want one.
OK, sit yourselves down. David, you've bonded.
I have.
You have bonded with her. You really have. Now, whilst Robbie
I'll just
and Gary
sit here with my peg. Hey, 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 hey.
Now, don't start, Vanity. I'd like you to put your hands together for my guests. Come on, for Danny Minogue. A born mother, look at her.
Oh, I know.
And for Mr. David Tennant. And, of course, me pigs. Right, folks. I think the boys are ready. This is the moment we've all been waiting for. It's their new single, Shame. Please welcome Mr. Robbie Williams and Gary Barlow.
Well, there's two versions of this story, mine and yours, and then the truth. Now we can cut it down to circumstance, our childhood, then our youth. Out of some sentimental gain, I wanted you to feel my pain, but it came back, returned to sender. I read your mind.
at all? Is this the sound of sweet surrender? What a shame we never listened. I told you through the television. And all that went away was the price we paid. People spend a lifetime this way. Oh, what a shame. So I got busy throwing everybody underneath the bus. At the back of Toys R Us, I wrote a letter in my mind, but the words were so unkind about a man I can't remember. I don't recall the reasons why I must have met them at the time. Is this the sound of sweet surrender? What a shame we never listened. Told you through the television, and all that went away was the price we paid. People spend a lifetime this way, and that's how they stay.
Look after yourselves. I'll see you on Friday, live at 9. Ta-da! Ta-da!